بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين بارئ الخلائق اجمعين الصلاه والسلام على اشرف الانبياء والمرسلين وخاتم النبيين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد
وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويوما يعض الظالم على يديه يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا يا ويلتى ليتني لم اتخذ فلانا خليلا لقد اضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا صدق الله العلي العظيم صلوات على محمد وعلى آل محمد
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد
Respected brothers and sisters, in our discussion about Surah Mubarakah Furqan, if you remember that all these verses are speaking about a day of Qiyamah. What is the scene of day of Qiyamah? What's happening there? What's going on there? And yesterday we of course discussed parts of that discussion about Qiyamah, and tonight verse number 27 continues. And these different scenes of Qiyamah or Day of Hereafter are very important because they show you where we went wrong or where those people who denied and rejected truth and haq, where they went wrong, what happened to them, on what spot, on what line. Now tonight again, very, very important problem in our lives is mentioned, which will have a great effect on the day of Qiyamah. Let me first translate for you. وَيَوْمَ يَعُدُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَىٰ يَدَيْهِ And on that day, oppressor and wrongdoer will bite his hands. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي أَتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا And he will say, if only I had followed the way with my Rasul, with my Messenger. يَا وَيْلَتَا يَا وَيْلَتَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا Oh, woe to me! I wish I never took so and so for a friend. Why I made that person my friend? لَقَدْ أَدَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ مَخَذُولًا He led me away from the message and a dhikr after it had come to me. For shaitan has always been a betrayer of men, a deserter of men, insulter of men and human beings. These are few verses, verse number 27, 28 and 29 of Surah Mubarakah, Ye Furqaan. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
As I mentioned, of course, it is speaking about Qiyamah and scenario of the day of hereafter. These verses have Shani Nuzul, means a story background. Something happened before revelation of these verses. There were two people in, you know, time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by the name of Aqaba and Ubay. And they were very close friends. And they also probably used to live far from each other. But whenever Ubay used to visit Aqaba, Aqaba used to put a feast. Big, you know, invite, people must come, eat, his friend is around. It appears that Aqaba by nature was a nice person. He was not Muslim, neither Ubay. But amazing that he had the greatest of respect for our Nabi and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. He used to invite him, used to visit him, used to pay respect to him, but he was not Muslim. Once when Ubay was around, Aqaba invited Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also to come and join for feast. And Prophet went, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Prophet refused to eat or touch the food. He said, why are you not eating? He said, I will not eat your food. I will not touch your food until you say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasul. Prophet said, I will not touch your food. You are a very good person, you invite me, you respect me, you visit me, but you don't listen. So, I'm here because you invite me, I'm not going to touch your food until you say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Now, this man, Aqaba, it shows what type of person he was. He said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan. Rasulullah became Muslim, accepted Islam. And Prophet ate his food. Afterward, Ubay challenged him, said, I come to know that you left the religion and deen of your forefathers because of this Muhammad. How you can do that? I am your friend, this and that. I'm not going to be any more friend with you. Now, they were very close friends. Aqaba said, but yes, and how I could have refused? Muhammad was leaving home without touching my food. That's a big insult for me. I can't take that a visitor comes, a guest comes, and does not eat from my food. And he said, he will not eat until you do not say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, shahadatain. So I have no option but to say that. Ubay said, then, that is your problem. I'm not anymore your friend. You want my friendship? Go back. Go back. Go back to your own religion. Don't accept this new religion. Aqaba, out of friendship, due to this friendship of Ubay, turned murtad. Became apostate. Turned murtad. And he said, okay, you are my friend, because of you I don't sign. Allahu Akbar. And not only became murtad, but I think he was killed in Battle of Badr. And Ubay was killed, I think, in Battle of Uhud as kafir. But a terrible story, huh? Now, about these two people, especially Aqaba, these verses were come, revealed. That in the day of Qiyamah, يَوْمَ يَعِدُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَوْ يَدَاهِ Allahu Akbar. That day he will regret and say, I wish I would have taken my path with Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I wish I wouldn't have taken so and so my friend. Right? Terrible. Now, let me just explain to you a few important points in this regard. First of all, يَعِذُ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ That oppressor bite, that day the oppressor will bite his hands. I'm not sure that in English this idiom or this expression exists or not. You know, when people regret, you know, they feel bad about themselves and they want to blame themselves for what they have done. They express that feeling of regret and remorse. Now in Arabic, even in Urdu, even in Persian, these expressions are there. The person bites his own hand or bites his tongue or something like that. I don't think in English, I think that is there, but maybe some other expression I'm not aware. But Quran is of course in Arabic saying that in the day of Qiyamah, out of regret, that person will bite his hand. Now why biting his hand? Very interesting. Because a regret is, what is regret? That you have done something wrong, now you have to suffer. And who is the reason? Yourself are the reason. And as a result, there is a psychological condition where you want to take revenge. But revenge from who? You cannot blame anyone. You yourself to be blamed for that. So somehow you react against yourself. You know, by hitting yourself or by biting your hand or doing something. And some people reach to the level of suicide basically. Why? Because they blame themselves. They think they can come, never come right. They are wrong. They are, you know, something is wrong with them. So they don't want to live anymore. And they don't want to live anymore and they want to die. So that is the reason. You know, one of the names of Day of Qiyamah is what in Surah Maryam, verse number 39. Yawmul Hasra, that Qiyamah is day of regret. People will regret a lot that day. They'll say, hey, wow, wish we could have done that. Wish we could have. And Mufassirin say something very beautifully, that in the day of Qiyamah, wrongdoers will regret, but even good doers also will regret. Bad doers, wrong doers will regret why they have done wrong. And good doers will regret why they have not done more good. Yawmul Hasra. It's a day of regret. Another important point here is, you know, issue of zikr. It says, you know, this regret becomes more terrible, more painful, more pinching, more difficult some to your soul and yourself when you had a chance, when you came very close to the guidance and then after reaching there all of a sudden you turn another way. Naturally, this regret becomes even worse. It feels more. What is in this case? It says, لَقَدْ أَذَلَّنْ This friend of mine misled me, misguided me. بَعْدَ أَنْ جَاءَنِي الذِّكْرِ After remembrance came to me, reminder came to me. Prophet came to me. After Allah's message reached me, and I was there, and then I turned back. Wow, feel regret, feel remorse, feel very bad, but doesn't have. Amazing, very interesting point. So in this story, who is to be blamed? Friend, friendship, which we'll talk about it now. But Quran concludes by saying that shaitan is for insan khazul. Means what? That sometimes shaitan comes in form of a friend. What is khazul? Let me tell you, what is khazalan? Khazalan means that if someone you depend on him, someone you rely on that person, someone you think he will support you, he's good, and then he leaves you in the middle of nowhere. That's called khazalan. Allahumma ansur man nasara wakhzul man khadala. O Allah, help those who help Ali. Ghadir, khutbah of Ghadir. Wakhzul man khadala. And leave alone those people who left Ali alone. Means originally, means what? Means originally you were together and then in the middle you leave it. This is quality of shaitan. This is attribute of shaitan. That shaitan comes to you in a very friendly, in a very reliable, somebody you can rely, somebody who can depend, you can depend on. He comes like that, but always leaves you in the middle, in the mass. So what to do with me is your trouble, not my trouble. Khazul, Quran says, for insan, shaitan is khazul. Shaitan is a deserter. Shaitan is not reliable. Shaitan leaves you alone. Anyway, the main issue, brothers and sisters, and last night I said, what is the main issue in this part? Quran is saying, Surah Furqaan is saying to us, if you remember, inkar of ma'ad, rejection of day of Qiyamah, one reason. Istikbar, arrogance, we yesterday spoke about it, another reason. And tonight Quran says, in the day of Qiyamah, there will be a group of people who will lose, who will be among losers. Why? Because of the friendship. Allahu Akbar. Very serious problem. Wrong friend, wrong company, destruction, destruction, destruction. And how serious is this issue in our own society? This whole phenomena of gangsterism, this whole phenomena of drugs, this whole phenomena of alcoholism, which are the most serious disease in our society, challenges to our society, destroying our youth. If you look at it, it starts from bad company and bad friendship. When we as parents, mashallah, so many of you are sitting, we do not want to worry about who is our child's friend. We take it very easy. He or she walks with someone, it's okay, he's young, he's okay. That okay of that day becomes a big, big trouble after a few years or few months even. Why, my brothers and sisters, let me know, come here, bring lesson home. Why we insist madrasa, madrasa, madrasa? Because madrasa provides you opportunity to make good company, good friends. You throw your children in the streets, you are at work, you come 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, tired, you have to make food, you have to look after the situation at house and home. I don't know, from 2 o'clock when child came back from school, till 6 o'clock, where he was missing, where he was moving, roaming around, making friends, but no, you don't worry, you don't mind. And when you even realize, you take it very easy. And that is the danger. That is the Ya laytani lam attakhidh fulanan khalila. In the day of Qiyamah, lot of people will say, I wish I wouldn't have made that person friend. And Quran and Islam and a school of Ahlulbayt have a great, great emphasis on this issue of friendship and company. In Ahadith, we got a special chapter called Adabul Muashira, means manners of association. Name of the chapter is Adabul Muashira, manners of association. What is friendship? You know, of course, again, time does not allow, but I can just give you a list of the things which are there. What is the meaning of friendship? How to choose a friend? Who can be friend? Who cannot be friend? What are the rights of a friend? Ayat, rivayat, plenty are there to, you know, explain to you. You know, friendship is, my brothers and sisters, so important. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
That you will not believe that you can basically work out personality. Now this is very interesting, listen. Work out personality of someone through his friends. I just want to read one or two ahadith for you as a sample, you know, just to understand how it is important. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Yes, hadith is from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Prophet of Islam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrates from Nabi Sulaiman. He says, La tahkum ala rajulin bishay'in hatta tanzuru ila man yusahib fa innama yu'rafu ar-rajulu bi ashqalihi wa aqranihi وَيُنْسَبُ إِلَىٰ أَصْحَابِهِ وَأَخْدَوْنِهِ. He said, don't judge anybody. Listen, good, very interesting. Don't judge anybody about anything until you look at who he is in company. فَإِنَّمَا يُعْرَفُ الرَّجُلِ. So indeed, man is recognized by his types, the ashkali, what type of person he is. The akrani, who are around him. وَيُنْسَبُ إِلَىٰ أَصْحَابِهِ. And he is always affiliated to his companions, to his friends, to his circle. Amirul Mu'minin Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wassalam says, فَمَنْ اشْتَبَهَ عَلَيْكُمْ أَمْرُ. If you were confused about somebody, you don't know, is he a good person, bad person, how is it, what type of personality this guy, فَمَنْ اشْتَبَهَ عَلَيْكُمْ أَمْرُ وَلَمْ تَعْرِفْ دِينَ. And you don't know his deen, that is he religiously committed person, is he mu'min, is he faithful person, is he committed or no, is he just like somebody with no care. فَانْزُرُوا إِلَىٰ خُلَطَوْهِ. Imam Ali says, then look at those people he mixed with them. فَإِنْ كَانُوا أَهْلَ دِينَ اللَّهِ. So if they are people of deen of Allah, فَهُوَ عَلَىٰ دِينَ اللَّهِ, then he is on deen of Allah. وَإِنْ كَانُوا عَلَىٰ غَيْرِ دِينَ اللَّهِ, and if they are on other than deen of Allah, فَلَا حَزَّ لَهُ مِنْ دِينَ اللَّهِ, he has no share from deen of Allah. You know, it's so important. It is so important that Imam Muhammad Baqir alayhi salatu was salam saying, Iyaka wa musahibatu sharir fa innahu kasayf al maslul yahsunu manzara wa yaqbahu asara. What a beautiful sentence. Imam Baqir is saying that a bad friend, musahibatu sharir, company of bad person, is like a sharp sword. It is very shining, it's flourishing, it's beautiful. In eye it look nice, but in effect it cuts very deep. In other words, friend, a bad friend is like a snake who got a lot of crabs, beautiful skin, but end of the day bites. Allahu Akbar. Another hadith let me read for you. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ka sara saduq narrated, Shaykh saduq narrated, Harun Barlam is narrated. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, arba'un yamutna al-qalb dhanb ala yamutna al-qalb yamutna al-qalb. There are four things which reasons which causes heart to die. Listen carefully. Prophet saying there are few things which results in the death of heart. Al-dhambu al-dhamb. First thing which makes your heart die, sin after sin. Allahu Akbar, ya Allah. When you commit a sin and you don't make tawbah and you commit again, that kills your heart. Wa majalisatul mauta. And company of dead people. Listen please, Prophet is saying company of dead people. Faqila ya Rasulallah, wa mal mauta. Who are dead people? You are saying company of dead people. Now he defines who are dead people. Qala kullu ghaniyin mutref. Allah. Ya Allah. Kullu ghaniyin mutref. He says, mauta and dead means rich people who are drunk in their wealth. Mutrif means they don't drink anything other than their money. Now, if you are in company of those people, you must know they will kill your heart. Heart means soul. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
As I said, too much is there to talk and speak. But really what I would like to remind my brothers and sisters and parents and youth who are here and those who will be listening on social media and so on, that please, selection of friend is very, very crucial in life. Don't, you know, what Imam Baqir said, kasayfil maslul, it's a poisoned sword, appears to be shining, attractive. Don't go just for that. Selection of friend is very crucial. Your whole future in this dunya and of course in akhirah depend on good friend, depend on good company. So if you want to take care of your children, parents, please be sensitive, please be careful, please be overcautious when it comes to who they meet and who they mix and where they go and where they come and who is with them. That is the message of these verses of Surah Furqaan. Ya laytani lam attakhir fulanan khabila. I wish I wouldn't have taken so and so my friend. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammadin.